From the Java Queen off the coast of Mondo Island, Captain Engelhorn radioed a warning to Professor Bond.
African bees, Professor. They're a Jove. There must be thousands of them.
I don't know if I'm to believe what I heard of these insects, but...
You should indeed believe every word of it, Captain. Get the Java Queen out of their path immediately. We'll dig in here. Over and out. Bobby, Susan, get busy with shovels. I'll collapse the tent over us. We ought to be able to hold out.
What are African bees, Dad?
Giant bees, Bobby, bred in Africa. They're the size of a man's fist, and they travel in swarms of thousands. They've been known to attack humans as well as livestock.
Will we be safe here?
All we have to do is dig in and keep still till they move on. They'll probably destroy the island, but we should be all right.
But, Dad, what about Kong?
Don't worry, son. I think I figured out a hiding place for him.
On the beach, the professor explains his plan.
This hollow log ought to do the trick. Tell him to put it in his mouth and lie down. He'll get the idea.
Pick it up, Kong. Like this. Lie down, Kong. Lie down. Wait till I come for you.
Completely submerged and breathing through the hollow log, Kong was quite safe from the giant insects.
See that cloud, Bobby?
You mean those are the African bees?
That's right. And they're moving this way fast. Let's get going.
The Bonds scurried back under the tent.
Well, we seem to be safe enough.
But I'd sure hate to be out there.
Meanwhile, aboard a small plane heading for Mondo Island...
I tell you, Sonny, I'm sinking a lot of money into this here science foundation of yours, and I aim to see that I gets my money's worth.
But I assure you, sir, only the most worthwhile project...
Listen, boy, a little surprise inspection keeps the troops on their toes. Put her down on the beach, Sonny.
Sir, the island seems to be fogged in. I don't understand it.
Sonny, when I say put her down, that means land the plane or look for another job.
What's that noise?
What noise?
No, I don't mean the bees. That other noise. It sounds like a motorboat or a plane.
It is a plane. And it's landing.
Well, we'll soon see about this. Shoddy management, I'd say. Follow me, sonny.
As the men left the plane, they were immediately set upon by the bees.
Yep! Hey!
Sir!
Ow!
Wait! I think... Oh!
Ouch!
I don't know who they are, but the fools walked right into the middle of it. I'll have to do what I can.
Oh, you're not going out there, Father.
Hand me the blowtorch, Bobby. And that mosquito netting.
Somebody...
Ow!
We'll...
Yay!
Pay...
Ow!
For this...
Professor Bond succeeded in holding the bees at bay with the torch, but...
The bees are still swarming around them. They're not afraid of the flame. What will happen when the fuel runs out in the torch?
If only Kong could hear me now, he'd be able to do something.
As though reading the boy's mind, the faithful giant did seem to hear. Heading for shore, he picked up a long boat and, filling it with water, doused the swarm of bees.
Now's our chance. Make for the tent.
Professor Bond, you better have an explanation for...
Move, you imbecile!
The mighty beast continued to lure the insects until the men were undercover.
Dad, they're chasing Kong.
Maybe he can lose them in the jungle.
They stopped. They know better than to tangle with Kong.
They're coming back this way, son. Get under cover.
Wait, Dad. Look.
As the bees turned at the edge of the clearing and headed back for the campsite, Kong came roaring back out of the jungle, again challenging the deadly bees. And again, they gave chase.
Oh.
did he do that for?
He did it because he's very brave, son.
Father, what are you going to do?
Kong has saved my life many times, Susan. I can't turn my back on him.
But, Father...
Listen, Bond. I want to straighten out a few things regarding your operation here.
Oh, be quiet!
In the jungle, the mighty beast was just one step ahead of the huge cloud of bees. But straight ahead lay his destination, the carnivorous garden where the insect-eating plants eagerly awaited the rare delicacy, African bees. Quickly, the cloud of insects disappeared as Kong looked on with pleasure. When Professor Bond caught up to him, he too approved of the gorilla's quick thinking.
My friend, you're a lot of monkey, but you're also part fox.